I got home and went into my little shelter, and they sent another one. I was having another thought. They sent another one. So I said, oh, this is in the bag, man. I went out on a step of faith, and I wrote a check for $20, $22.33, and there's only $10.99 in the account. I know it's not going to get pulled out of my public account. All they got to do is press the button. Once I receive that check, they'll see, because they know who I am. They know all the processes that I went through. They know that I completely took myself off the system, out off cash, no utilities, no water, no electricity, no nothing, no food stamps, no nothing. I don't pay for nothing. I just go to the food bank, get free stuff there, and I go to Catholic Community Services and get free toothpaste, free showers, free wood. And I faced all the giants, all the attorneys, all their letters, all their mails, process servers, sheriffs, cops, knocking on the door, coming into my yard, everything. Paperwork down at the courthouse. I faced the state taxes. I faced the IRS. I faced them all. And I came out spotless and peaceful. And they know it. And now I'm sitting under injury. And I'm recording all this stuff, or I'm publicizing all this stuff from my backyard on my imaginary radio program called Russell Radio 88.8 IM. So that's public record. That's as good as any sidewalk, as any courthouse. I put everything in the public record. All the neighbors know everything. And I said, I am under injury. I'm in the public under injury because my lien's not being honored. So I went to go visit my relatives, and my relative gave me a clue as to how to access that account. And as soon as my relative told me, I says, oh man, this is going to work. I know it. I feel it. And sure enough, it's been 4 days for my first check that I wrote. I wrote it February the 4th on Wednesday. Today's Sunday. Ain't nothing been taken out of the account. I know this other one's good too. All the signs are telling me. I know it. It's in my bones. Plus, I know this too. I've been saying on my videos, I'm going to manifest an ATM card to that account. And I already have an ATM card to my checking account. So all I got to do is just do a little more finagling, some experimenting, figure out how to use it to make it work. And I already got it set up. And I thought it was going to come in the mail, but I already have it right on my body. People, I'm totally private, but I wear all the clothing of the citizen. I can pay for everything. I can pay for tags, registration, license plates, traveling expenses, green cards, passports, everything. I can go through airports, travel any country I want, because I can pay for it just like usual, and I can show my ID and say, hey, this is who I am. But if anything goes down where they want to try to collect from me, like a body, my body and all that, they can't do it because I'm untouchable as long as I keep the peace. So we don't have to be scared going through airports, buses, pat downs, checks. In fact, that stuff is necessary. When you start to understand peace and safety of the earth and the terrorist things that we do in life today, you understand that everything has to be totally checked. That's just common sense, peace and safety. You don't let people on your plane that you think might have a bomb on them, or a gun, or what have you. You have to get yourself checked. But like I say, once you know who you are, you can operate right in commerce as a strong man and a private man, walking side by side. You just got to have perfect understanding. And you're golden. So I'm going to be able to start purchasing all the stuff that I want now. All my necessities in life, build my guitar, Disneyland, and all that. I already got property picked out and everything. So, get ready. Because this brother is going to spread the word, teach private maritime law, and it's going to spread across the country like fire. And as it goes in America, so it goes in the rest of the world. Get ready. Because it's all my blood. From the tribe of Judah and the Iroquois Indians. If you know any studies about the Iroquois and the tribe of Judah, you're golden. So I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.